Hi scholars, welcome to our channel Academia Unlimited. So finally, the winter holiday season is here and many of us would flock to Goa in the coming days. We will hit the beaches, sip cool drinks in the shacks and stroll leisurely in flea markets. Some would visit the forts and other historical monuments, while some would relish in the Goan cuisine. Let us go a bit deeper and feel the soul of Goa. In this video, we will talk briefly about the history and culture of Goa. Now, on Facebook and Instagram, we come across many pages of travel enthusiasts who cover entire countries in one single day. There is one Instagram travel page which I follow, and the travel enthusiast there has covered 181 countries in 181 days. Now, this is insane traveling. The whole purpose of making this video is that if you plan to go to Goa, you should have in your mind a few interesting facts about the history and culture of Goa. So, without wasting any time, let's talk about it. The name of Goa is derived from the name of a kingdom known as Goa Rashtra or Gopa Rashtra, which was ruled by the Yadavas mentioned in the Mahabharata age. This dynasty of Yadavas is the same dynasty to which Lord Krishna belonged to. The words Goa or Gova or in Konkani, Gonya refers to the holy cow, and thus Goa refers to the land of cowherds. Goa has seen human habitations since millennia. It was the home of the early man who lived in caves located in dense jungles. Even today, we can see the rich rock art they left behind. During Mauryan Emperor Ashok's time, Buddhist monks popularized Buddhism in Goa. Jainism prospered in Goa under the rule of Kadamba dynasty. Goa was also a part of the Vijayanagar Empire. When the Portuguese annexed Goa in 1510, it was ruled by the Adil Shahi dynasty of Bijapur. The Portuguese admiral who gained this victory was named Alfonso de Albuquerque. Now, Alfonso de Albuquerque was a very militarily powerful man who is known for his military genius. But at the same time, there are a few infamous things associated with him. In the fierce battle of 1510, when the Portuguese were victorious, then Alfonso de Albuquerque ordered his officers and his aristocrats to marry the widowed wives and other women of the harem of the Bijapuri warlords, aristocrats and officers. Speaking of the Portuguese excesses, one thing which comes to our mind is the Inquisition of 1560, when, in the name of religion, for the sake of promoting Christianity, a lot of atrocities were committed on the innocent population of Goa. Anyways, since 1510, Goa enjoyed the special status of being the capital of the Portuguese Empire in Asia. The Portuguese rule continued in Goa till 1961, when it was liberated from colonialism and made a part of independent India. This could happen because of Operation Vijay, wherein the Indian Army marched into Goa. Now, scholars, coming back to the point which was raised in the introduction, how do we get a darshan of the real Goa? Or how do we get under the skin of Goa? So, for that, I will suggest a few things which you should do before going on a long holiday trip to Goa. First of all, refer to the works of Mario Miranda. Now, Mario Miranda was a very famous, iconic cartoonist who hailed from Goa. His family had roots in Goa stretching for several centuries, and he himself was a very gifted artist. Even today, if you land at Goa airport or if you go to any bookshop in Goa, in Panjim or any other town, you can easily find new books of Mario Miranda's caricatures and cartoons. And scholars, mark my word, you will really see such splendid art in those cartoons. You will see the different tribes and communities which inhabited Goa since centuries, and you will see the Christian impact, you will see the Muslim impact. Actually, you will see the entire culture and the entire panorama of Goan life in Mario Miranda's art. The second suggestion that I wish to make is that whether you physically visit or not visit, some architectural splendors of Goa, you at least have a look at them on Google. And in these architectural splendors, we could include the Hindu temples. There are some breathtakingly beautiful temples in Goa. For example, there is this very beautiful Mahadev temple, which was built by the Kadambas, by the Kadamba dynasty, in around 7th, 8th century AD. Then you can also visit the beautiful forts. You can visit Chapora Fort, you can visit Cabo de Rama. There are so many forts, the Fort Aguada. Interestingly, scholars, I would like to mention here that Cabo de Rama is basically a Portuguese fort, but its history goes back to the time of Ramayana. So like I said, the Goan culture dates back to millennia, and you see, like the pages of a book, you see in Goa different cultures, different time periods unfolding before your eyes. Then if you talk about the churches, they are magnificent, they are mind-boggling. You can see the Basilica of Bom Jesus, and the whole old Goa or Vela Goa town is full of miraculous architecture built in the form of churches. Speaking of the forts, there is a fort in North Goa which is called Tiracol Fort. Now it's a very interesting piece of architecture, and it is also related to the history of liberation of Goa. In this Goa, a few freedom fighters and Congress workers, they laid down their lives facing Portuguese fire, and their demand was that Goa should be as soon as possible merged or united with independent India. The last suggestion that I want to make to you is that please go and watch Shyam Benegal's brilliant movie Trikal. This was an amazing movie made in 1980, and it stars Nasiruddin Shah, Nina Gupta, Leela Naidu, and a host of other stalwarts and experts, master craftsmen, master artists from the Bombay film industry. And in this drama, you actually get to see the Portuguese culture, how the Portuguese elite, the Portuguese aristocracy used to actually live in Goa. What was their lifestyle? What beautiful houses they built? What was their culture? What were the different sort of societal structures that they were living in? So with this, I would end this video. And again, I would say the whole purpose of making this video is that before having that ideal holiday in Goa, which is hailed as the holiday capital of India, please go through this video and enjoy Goa with a slight understanding of its culture and history. Thanks a lot for tuning in. Also, thanks a lot for being through the entire video. Please do like it, share it. Also, subscribe to our channel, Academia Unlimited, for more such fun. Have a nice day. Thank you. Bye-bye.